was back in the early 2000s. We're going to try to give you a mulligan on that one. Let's see. There you go. You're on top of it, buddy. 2002, Freedom 100 winner. All right, looks like the Southern All-Stars B-Main number one about to get going here. Chad Ogle, he's your race leader. Skylar Mollar, he'll start beside him. Vic Hill, second row inside. Jensen, forward to the outside. Bobby Mason inside of row number three. Jeff Wolfenbarger to the outside of row three. Riley Hickman, he'll get it. They come out of turn four. They get to the loud pedal. Green flags in the air. Here we go. And as to plan, they did not like that start, so we're going to retry it again here. We'll be giving out some more of these Scott Sexton posters as we continue to run trivia throughout the night. And we're also going to do a little Southern All-Star trivia coming up later on as we'll give a few of that away as well. So we're going to try to get this all re-geared back up and ready to roll. Here they come out of turn four. Green flags in the air. They're going to run off into turns one and two. And they're going to scream them hard out of turn three and four. Down the front stretch they go. Back out in turns one and two. We got some great racing in the PPM Products Constellation Race number one. 10 laps the distance in between competitors. Skylar Marlar showing the way to Vic Hill down that back stretch. He's got that Clements motor hooked up and humping down the front stretch he goes. Great racing out of turn number four. Field back, single file. They come back to the straight. Skylar Marlar checking out from the rest of the field. Vic Hill right now sitting in second. Jensen Ford up to third. Chad Ogle. Bobby Mays fourth. Chad Ogle. Round out your top five at the moment. They'll come around halfway in, halfway to go. They'll cross the stripe for lap six. Skylar Marlar putting on a clinic in the PPM Products. B-Main number one, and he is checking out from the rest of the field. He has got that Clements motor screaming hard around this high bank for a 10-mile oval. Victor Thrill Hill got that Longhorn chassis looking good as he runs second. Jensen Ford sits in third. Chad Ogle sits in fourth. Everybody will make the show. Riley Hickman back there still holding on. White flag is out as they see the rest of the field cross the stripe. Coming out for picking up the BPM Products. B-Main number one. Give it to Skylar Marlar. Vic Hill a transfer on in. As well as Jensen Ford, Chad Ogle, and Jeff Wolfenbarger. That rounds out your top five. All right, the Southern All-Star officials letting them know that these guys are going green next time by. Again, 10 laps is the distance. And Here we go, out of turn four. They get to that loud pedal. Here we go. And they're going to fire off into turns one and two down the backstretch. They go Dylan Tidmore. He's going to take the point. Mark Van is going to try to bottom in. He will fall back to third as they cross the stripe. Dylan Tidmore, he's got to try to hold off that 85 machine of Mark Dotson. Dylan Tidmore, the lone Alabama driver, trying to get into the victory lane. One of three different states being represented this evening. How about that? Mark Dotson gonna take a swipe to the inside. He's gonna run up the track, lose that momentum, and fall back about three or four car lengths. That's the big thing we'll talk about earlier. This track is very known for all that high momentum. Mark Van is gonna take a peek to the inside of Mark Dotson as they come to the stripe. Halfway in, halfway to go. They'll get six laps as they cross the stripe this time by. Only four laps left on the book. Dylan Tidmore go high, wide, and handsome. He'll go three to go this time by. Topside very slick as they get into that gray burned in groove. Two to go. The bullhorns are out for the field as Dylan Tidmore come across. Coming out of turn four, one more time around for the gassed and gas man as he jumps down the straightaway. Mark Dotson sits second, Mark Vigna third. Ellery Leach sits fourth. Coming out of turn four, picking up the PPM products. B-Main number two, the gassed and gas man, Dylan Tidmore. Second going to Mark Dotson, third to Mark Vigna. Fourth to Ellery Leak and round out your top five, Dale Ball. Next up will be the Sportsman. One of the most beautiful sights in racing. And here they are. The juggernauts of the Sandlot, the baddest boys with the biggest toys. Here are your Southern All-Stars Super Late Model Series. Wave to them because they're waving back at you. Take your picture, wave your hat, flap your arms, even wave your mother-in-law. These guys are about to do battle here on this 4/10 mile speed plant. He's got the one. Got the flag in his hand, letting them know we're gonna turn them loose next time they out of turn four. They're about to tuck them in tight. 800 plus horsepower of high octane fuel and adrenaline is about to excite East Tennessee tonight at the Volunteer Speedway. David Pay, Mark Douglas, that is your front row. They come out of turn four. The famous words of MC Hammer. It is Hammer time on four. Mark Dunn is going to slide high down the backstretch. Look at Ray Cook going to get the run down the backstretch. David Payne's going to try to fight him off on the high side. The field spinning three and four wide on turn four. Give it to Mark Douglas at the line. They fire back off in the turns one and two. Look at that runner, David Payne, in that Capital car. He got that Jay Dickens all over that other Capital car, Ray Cook, as they come to the line. Man, oh man, these guys are screaming hard down that backstretch. Mark Douglas got that 52D dialed in. The number 52 is looking good right now. They're three laps into this one as they're checking them off. Donald Joe McIntosh trying to work the bottom side, trying to get around Roger Best for that top five position. Great battle between Corey the Hedgecock for the sixth position as he's going to battle with Ryan King as they go into turns one. Big pileup trying to get squared up. Look at Riley Hickman to the bottom. The two-time defending Southern All-Stars champion coming up to the front early in this one. He said he's going to go to the bottom and make it work. Look at him working on that number 83 machine as they go into turns one and two. Chad open that 10 trying to hold him off. Look at D-Mac, Donald Mac. Running fourth, coming after, trying Roger Best to crack the top five. You better keep your eyes on Ray Cook. He has got that 53 Capital Race Engine Design machine moving as he has now ran down Mark Vineyard as they go into turns one. Mark Vineyard doing battle with Dylan Tidmore. The number two of Dale Ball is off the pace. Ray Cook won back here in April with the Carolina Clash as he took the win over Victor Thrill Hill. Mark Douglas knows he's back there. He better tighten up because he got a whole host of drivers behind him trying to get to him. And it didn't take long. They're already in the lap traffic. They're approaching lap number 10 of the event. You're going to see that lap move over car flag come out very early. Mark Douglas, he's going to try to calm it down the backstretch. See if he can hold off Ray Cook as they go into turns three and four. David Payne, Jason Welshen, Roger Best, Donald Mack. Look at that top six on front to toe, back to back on each other. You better not bobble up front. Look at Jason Wilson to the bottom under David Payne as they come to the line. These guys has got those high-octane V8 800-plus horsepower machines working hard on this speedway. Donald Mack is determined to make that bottom side work as he works on. And he's going to, wow, what a way to shut the door on Roger Best as he moves up to fifth. Mark Douglas going to work on lap traffic. Corey Hedgecock, he's going to shut it down and bring it in, and his night is now over. Jason Welshen to the inside of David Payne off turn number two. Mark Douglas trying to hold off Ray Cook in lap traffic. Three wide off four. What a race as they come to the stripe. David Payne, Ray Cook pushing up on each other. They go into turns one and two. Ray Cook going to use the high side to pull away as they battle. Three wide for that fourth position. What a race for second tonight. These guys are putting on a show. Mark Douglas checking out. Ray Cook to the bottom. The battle for the lead is on. Ray Cook all over him. Uh-oh, Jeff Wolfenbart is going to get in the way. Wow, Ray Cook. Going to put the move to him. They're going to go three wide for the lead. David Payne at the bottom. Ray Cook in second. Mark Douglas, he's going to lead them. They're going to battle hard on four. Ray Cook, he ain't giving up. What a battle down the front stretch. These guys are got their hands full with that lap traffic. The number 34 machine a little bit off the pace. Mark Douglas again trying to hold off Ray Cook in the turns one and two. Ray Cook to the bottom of the speedway. He's going to take a shot at him down the backstretch. David Payne, D-Mac, Donald Mack, Jason Welshen. That battle for third is getting hot and heavy. The battle up front is like the Waffle House special at midnight. Everybody's after it. They want that lead. What a battle in the turns one and two. Ray Cook now up to a half a car lead behind Mark Douglas. Donald McIntosh now up to fourth. He has passed Jason Welshen. Now he's going to work the top side out of four as they come to the strike. Seemed like lap traffic is put just a small hint of breathing room between first and second place. Donald McIntosh not giving up on David Payne. What a battle back there for third. You better keep your eyes on those two. They're starting to reel down the leaders. They're less than 2/3 of a second behind. This track has got a very good prep on it. Top side, bottom side, they are racing all over this speedway. Donald McIntosh now up to third out of four. They're closing up on halfway. Mark Douglas still holding on. Ray Cook down to the bottom out of four. He's going to put the fender up under him. Mark Douglas going to check away. Look at Jason Welshen getting caught up with the 34 machine of Ultry as they battle down the backstretch. I tell you what, you better keep your eyes on that Blunt Motorsports entry of the number 7, Donald McIntosh. He is now running down your leaders. Ray Cook to the inside down the backstretch. And what a battle all four. Mark Douglas, he's going to fight him into turns 1 and 2. They're going to get at it. Ray Cook not giving up. What a battle down the backstretch. Ray Cook's not going to let him up. They're going to square off. Donald McIntosh is now in the picture. We got a hell of a race tonight. Ray Cook not giving up down the backstretch. Exit stage right, says the Pussycat, and he's going to power around Donald McIntosh on this front stretch. There are 29 laps in and a 52-lap feature. Donald McIntosh to the bottom. He's going to work on Ray Cook out of four. And the battle for the lead continues to get hot. Oh, my God. Look at Donald McIntosh. He's coming for the lead down the backstretch. We got a hell of a race in a 3 and 4. Caution's going to wave. Wow. Looks like the Tar Heel Tiger, Ray Cook, going to decide to take the bottom route. So Donald McIntosh will go to the outside. David Payne will line up the inside of row two, and the rest of the field will follow on in behind. To go for Mark Douglas if he can hold on, but the Tar Heel Tiger and D-Mac are both ready to make a stab at him. They're gonna come out of turn four. That green flag's in the air. Here we go. And they're gonna barrel off into turns 1 and 2. Donald Mack's gonna lock it up. They're gonna go 3 wide for that fourth position down the backstretch. Mark Douglas tucks it to the bottom. Here comes Donald Mack. He'll get second at the line. Mark Douglas better shift it into high gear. Here comes the Ray Cook. The Tar Heel Tiger has sharpened his claws and ready to dig him into the 52D. Ray Cook on the top side. Here he comes. He's got a catapult down the back stretch. Uh-oh, look at that rabbit. He's going to hop on down to the front stretch. We got a new leader. Now Donald McIntosh going to try to take a stab at Mark Douglas. Josh Henry sitting back there. 3 wide on four. What a race. Jason Welshen, he fires on Ash. Afterburners, he's coming after him for that third position. David Payne trying to hold off Josh Henry for fifth. Donald McIntosh, determined to make that bottom side work. Ray Cook checking out as he's all the way high, wide, and handsome on four. He's going to drive it in turns 1 and 2 and take off from the rest of the field. The incredible straightaway speed these guys are carrying. This is a high momentum track. You got to be on your game. You bobble just a hair and it will send you back 2 to 3 positions. Jason Welshen using that top side for all it's worth. Donald Mack up under Mark Douglas down the backstretch. They got a battle hard off for the battle for second is on. David Payne, Jason Welch, and Roger Best laying down some good laps right now. These guys are clicking them off. There are less than 10 laps to go. They're up down to 9. Ray Cook driving away from this field tonight. Mark Douglas sitting there in second, trying to hold off Don McIntosh. The battle for second. They're going to run down this front stretch. The Dawsonville, Georgia driver all over that Tennessee Terror veteran. They're going to keep fighting it out as they go down the back stretch. McIntosh hadn't gave up the fight yet. He's going to bring it back to him as they go into turns 1 and 2. He's going to go to the bottom again. He's got the momentum on his side as he gets up under him again. Six laps in the book. 52 laps are the distance. Laps are winding down. Dylan Tidmore is going to go to the bottom as Ray Cook takes it up top. Going to put him a lap down. Whoa! What a crossover by Ray Cook as they come to the line. Man, this battle for second is not giving up. Donald McIntosh giving Mark Douglas all he wants and some. He's all that in a bag of chips. He's trying to catch that 2-for-1 hot dog special. He's going to run him all the way down that backstretch. What a race. Don't count out David Payne as he is trying to hold off Josh Henry back there for that fifth position. In the books, 52 the distance. They're going to get the bull horse 2 to go this time by. The flagman has let them know. We got a 3-car fight for that second position. One more time around for Ray Cook. Mark Douglas, Donald McIntosh, Jason Wilson. They're going to keep slugging it out, but picking up the third angle, Scott Sexton Memorial. Give it to Ray Cook. Donald Mack at the line. He'll take second. Mark Douglas third. Jason Wilson fourth. And round out your top 5. Give it to David Payne.
All righty. Well, all right. You're earning another name, man. We're going to start calling you Big Play Ray. Because every time when the money is on the line, you seem to always make those big plays work. Did you think you had some for Mark Douglas tonight early in that feature?
Well, I mean, just first of all, thank the Lord for a great night. And, you know, that looked like something that Scott would have done, some kind of move he'd have tried to make, you know. But we just thank the Lord and thank all of our sponsors. And, you know, I felt like we had a good car tonight. The motor wasn't really running qualifying. We put new plugs in it, but you know, Jay Dickens and Capital Race Cars, GW Performance, and Joe Denby with A-plus moving, just everybody that helps us. I wouldn't be here without them all. Tommy Pope, Joey Phillips, but felt like we had a good car. But you know, that top is just so dominant, and I knew when he moved to the middle, maybe if I could start making that work up there and get a run on him. But you never know. I mean, you can't plan. You gotta. Just take advantage of it when you can and hope you don't wreck. So.
Oh, yeah, man. One of the big storylines coming into this event, will Tennessee manage to hold on to that stranglehold of 5 consecutive straight wins? And you're the first driver to break the Tennessee hold on a Tennessee track, honoring a Tennessee legend. How does that feel, buddy?
Well, it makes us feel good. And, you know, Scott Sexton could race anywhere in the United States. It wasn't just in Tennessee. And I seen him win in North Carolina, where I'm from, too. So, you know, we're just proud to win a race in his honor, and thank all the fans for coming out and all his family, you know, that's here. And I just hope they had a really good time.
Most certainly. You just touched earlier on the man that we're honoring for this event. You're a longtime veteran and raced for many, many years, and you raced Scott Section on many different occasions here, Bulls Gap and other. Is tonight would have been one of those nights if he was still with us, you'll be able to fight him for that win, man?
Well, I promise you, he'd have been right up against that wall where I was. That was he made that line famous before anybody did here in Atomic and Tazewell, you know, and he set the benchmark for a lot of people. But the thing about Scott was the most important thing is he gave his life to the Lord, you know, when he got older, and that's what I remember him most for, because I know I'll get to see him again.
Yes, sir. And there we go. Let's hear it one more time for Big Play Ray Cook. Yes, sir. We got a member of the Sexton family. That his son, you look just like him too, buddy. Yes, sir. The son of Scott Sexton would like to give a word for our contingencies.
I'd just like to thank all you fans for coming out here and enjoying the race. All these race car drivers put on a great show. All these race car drivers come out here and put on a show for you guys, and it was a great show, and I know that my old man would have wanted it the same way that it turned out. So thank all you fans and thank all you drivers for coming out.
Say it one more time.
Just wanted to thank all you fans and thank all you drivers for coming out, because this was the way my old man would have wanted it.
There we go, from Mr. Sexton's son himself, man. All right, we're going to go down to our second place finisher. Place runner-up here at the third annual Scott Sexton Memorial. All right, D-Mac, you took it to him last night holding off Case Roberts at 411. You come up just a little bit short tonight to pull in the weekend sweep. How was this car handling for you, buddy?
Car was awesome. That caution hurt us a little bit. I think tire tried to seal up on that long caution there, but we had a great car. I can't thank the guys enough. Vic Hill Race Engines, Rocket Chassis, Stowers Cat, Massey Electric, Cherokee Millwright. We had an awesome car tonight. It was awesome racing with Ray and Douglas there. We run side by side for so many laps. That was fun, and I don't think we ever touched. So it was an awesome race tonight.
Well, in that event, man, you started a little bit deeper in the field, and you went to the bottom of something a little undifferent, that catfish line that we like to call it. Did you think that bottom was going to be enough to succumb to the top side?
Well, I just was tired of riding around in line, so I'm like, I got to try something that they're not doing, and the bottom was the only place to go, and the car was working really good down there, so you know, it was just our night to be on the bottom.
Oh, certainly, man. You put on a fantastic race, and good job on a second place run, man. Here's your second place runner-up, D-Mac Donald McIntosh. And here he is, our third place man here at the Scott Sexton Memorial, Mark Douglas. Mark, you started up front outside the pole. You led majority of the race over halfway before eventually succumbing to Ray Cook. Did you know that he was on the outside of you there, man?
No, I think he showed me the nose there a couple of times in the bottom. And I said, well, you know, the high side's going away because I've been running the high side all night. And, I started moving down, just thought it might get more traction since the top might be going away. But I think the longer we run, the left rear tire started going away, and I started losing traction. And I think McIntosh had a little harder left rear than I did, so he come on there at the end. But it just finally wore my left rear out, and then it started spinning, started losing traction.
Most certainly, man. Up to prior point before the caution came out, you, Ray Cook, Donald McIntosh, Jason Welshen, you couldn't throw a blanket all over you. Could you feel all those guys around you up there early in this one?
Well, I was trying to just focus on hitting my marks. I try not to worry about, you know, where they're at. You know, I felt like Ray Cook and Donald, you know, was probably real close. The way they've been running up here and stuff, we've been having a lot of bad luck. Hopefully we can get a little momentum running and, you know, maybe start to get some top fives out of the deal. But I did feel them back there, I think, you know, just one of them deals that you can just tell that they're there, you know, and lap traffic, you come up on lap traffic, I know, it's like, man, I hope I hit the right marks at the right time. Maybe I could squirt away for another lap or two. But all in all, third place, I'm tickled to death with it just to come out here. Nothing hurt, didn't tear up nothing, and everything. I'd like to thank all the crowd to come out to support Scott Sexton and everything. You know, he was one of my great friends and stuff. I actually started racing go-karts with him a long time ago, and finally I got into late model racing, and David Bryant and Scott actually wanted to help me get started in this stuff. So I'd really like to pull off a win for him, but I'm sure he'd be tickled with a third. And like I say, thanks for everybody who shows up, and thanks to Joe Love and Phyllis for putting on a good show in honor of Scott Sexton.
Yes, sir. Let's hear it up one more time for your third place finisher, Mark Douglas.